So I am making a mobile game, and I want to play test my project on my mobile phone quickly, easily, and for free. None of this developer's kit nonsense. Well, using the Unreal Remote 2 is a real option, and today we're going to cover where to get it, how to set up your project to use it, and how well it works. There are three things that you'll definitely need to play test your game. Number one, a computer to run Unreal Engine 4. Number two, a mobile device with specs good enough to use the app. And number three, an internet connection. I should mention that I had some difficulties getting Unreal Engine 4.25 to work with the app. After checking online, it looks like, yeah, the app isn't perfect and can be a bit finicky. The first thing we'll need to do is install the app on our mobile device. Unreal Remote 2 is available on the Apple App Store and the Google Play Store. Go ahead and install the app. Next, we'll need to open the project that we want to playtest and enable one plugin. Under the Edit tab, click on Plugins and search for the plugin called Remote Session. Enable it and restart the editor. Now we can play the level, but make sure to select Play this level in a new window or in a standalone game. The last step we'll need to do is launch the app and allow it to access our local network, which has to be the same internet connection that our computer's using. To get our remote address, which is our IP address, we'll have to go to our settings on our computer, click on our network and internet, and go to the properties of our network. Scroll down to the bottom, and the IP address that we'll need is the IPv4 address. I'm going to blur out all of my information for privacy, but type in your IP address into the app and then click Connect on the app. Now, as long as your project is playing the level in a new window or standalone game, the app should automatically connect to your project and your mobile inputs should be accurate. Keep in mind that your latency will be determined by your hardware and internet connection. I don't have the best of either of those, so I do have quite a bit of lag on my phone, but the desktop responds to the inputs from my mobile device basically instantly. These steps should work for any project, but like I said earlier, I did run into some connection issues with 4.25 where the app just wouldn't detect the editor. Alright, that's it for playtesting our mobile game on a mobile device. Hopefully this video helped you with your project. Don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. I appreciate you watching this video, and remember to stick around for more informative videos on Unreal Engine 4.